So this is a good little exercise because it's going to basically test everything you theoretically should know already. So this is going to be like a career finder, kind of like one of those, oh, you like dogs, so you should be a vet. And you're like, no, that sounds gross. And they're like, oh, you should be a dog groomer. And you're like, no, I don't work that hard. They're like, you should be a dog petter. And you're like, yes, that's the dog for me. So what we want to do is create a career finder where you're going to ask people for their name and based on links and blah, blah, blah. So all the directions are here. So pause the video, give this a shot, see how far along you can get. It won't be that bad. It'll be amazing. You'll love it. So anyway, give this a shot, see how far you can get. Pause the video, come back, and we'll work it together. So we'll pretend that happened. Yay! All right. So we're going to ask for their name. So what's your name? So your name. I'm going to say input, what's your name? And because I want them to be able to enter a string without getting yelled at, I'm going to put that. Okay, so what's your name? Now I want to know how long their name is. So without too much difficulty, I can say, you know, name length or whatever is equal to the length of the name. So I don't actually have to do that. What I can do is I'm actually going to put this all into an if statement on its own. So I'm going to say if the length of the name is less than or equal to 3, and I don't care what pictures or numbers you pick, so just pick whatever you want. If the length of the name is less than or equal to 3, I'm going to put them in a service job. So I'm just going to display service job for a moment. Else, if the length of the name is greater than 3 and less than or equal to 5, then I'm going to say they're going to do a retail job. And then otherwise, they're going to do a think tank job. So you can make this better. You could say it looks like you're best suited for a service job. Let me ask you another question. Okay. So I'm going to do that. So it looks like you're best suited for a service job. Let me ask you another question. So now I'm going to ask for their favorite color. So the best way for me to do this is probably to do an input statement, not an input statement, but a menu statement. That way I'm not like checking to see how they spelled yellow. So color, I'm going to say menu, what's your favorite color? And your options are red, magenta, or not selected, or not one of these. They're not a whole lot of options. So what's your favorite color? Red, magenta, or not one of these? So now I'm going to switch on that. So I'm going to switch on the color selection. There's going to be the case 0, the default case. There's going to be the case 1, which is red. There's going to be the case 2, which is magenta. There's going to be the case 3, which is none of the above. And then I'm going to end that. So make sure that you end your switch statement, because it's pretty common for people to forget to end things. So anytime you have something that opens up, you should have something that closes. So if they didn't pick anything, I can say, since you didn't pick anything, you're probably best, what's a service job? Opt not to work at all. So there we go. So I don't really care what you tell them to do. I'm just trying to show you how to start it. Since you like red, you should pick up paper. That's a service job? Picking up paper? I don't know. What am I doing? You should be anger management counselor. Can't spell counselor. And then I say, since you like magenta, you should, I don't know, what's a good service job that's fun? You should be a babysitter. That's totally fun. And none of the above. since you're picky, you should be a, no, what do you do when you are picky and you're in service? You should be a fashion critic. Is that a service job? I don't know. It doesn't matter. That's not the point. All right, you should be a fashion critic. Okay. So, all right, so I did that. Now, if they're a retail job, how much money do you want to make a year? So this would be a numerical entry. So basically, I'm just doing this to show you that you can combine every single thing in all these different ways. So salary is going to be equal to how much do you want to make? So I could say something like that. How much do you want to make? So I could say if they want a salary of less than, I don't know, $40,000, then I could say work at, I don't know where people work. I work at a school. Work at Best Buy. I don't know how much people make at Best Buy. I don't want to get in trouble for saying people make money in certain places and don't make money in other places. Work at a donut shop. There, now nobody can get upset at me for copyrights. Else, if their salary is greater than or equal to $40,000 and salary is less than $50,000. Now, I'm going to just say this on the side. Sometimes people will say if salary is greater than or equal to $40,000 and less than $50,000, okay, you can't do that. You can't say greater than and less than like that. You actually have to put the word salary in there again. So if your code isn't working a whole lot, that could be wise. You need to list that twice. You say, if this is less than this and this is less than this. You can't just say, if this is this and this. You have to say, if this is blah and this is blah, not if this is blah and blah. Okay, does that make sense? So you have to have that listed twice. So if you want to make that much money, you should work at a button store, because people who make buttons sell buttons do that. Otherwise, then they want to make more. You should work at a jacket lining store. I'm running out of ideas. Okay. So there you go. Now, if you're a think tank job, we just want to randomly generate a number. So in order to do that, I can say some random number, and that's just going to give me a random number on its own. I can say if the random number is less than, say, 0.3, what's a good think tank job? Think of political opinions. Political opinions? Else if rand is, now I actually don't have to do this because it doesn't matter. I'm just going to keep doing it because I've been doing it. And it's less than 0.8. Then I went to think of ways to make erasers more chill. I don't know what that means. Otherwise, I want to think of the rainbow connection. So now basically what you've got is you've got this just really stupid code, but what it's going to do is it's got like 30 different ways of doing something, and that's one of the reasons I kind of like this stupid example, is even though it's really stupid, it involves like pretty much everything. So we start off with getting a string as an input, because that's your name. We have to remember how to find the length of the name, and now we have this if and else if and else statement based on that. So then we have the menu, which we usually pair with a switch case. And then we have a non-string based input. So if you put S here, then it's going to treat the value that you're entering like a string, and you don't want that to happen. So you don't want to have that there. So then we have this non-string input, and then if and else if and all that. And then we're just going to come up with a random number in general and go from there. So let's see how this works. So what's my name? My name is Bugaboo. So I have a long name. So that means I'm going to be a think tank. I'm going to think of the rainbow connection. So, yay. Let's see here. So I'm going to do this again. My name is still Bugaboo. And wait, I want a different answer. It should give me something different. That's weird. Why does it keep giving me a rainbow connection? Oh, there we go. So it just kept generating a random number greater than 8. So I want to keep doing this until I get all of them just to make sure it works. Okay. So that means I'm getting to see all of these options. So it's really important whenever you're making code that you're really going to test it. So it freaked me out a little bit that I got rainbow connection 3 times in a row, but that's just the way the random number generator happened to be. So I know that if my name of the length of my name is a 4 or a 5, chug, then I have a retail job. So if I want to make $30,000 a year, I work at a donut shop. And really I'm doing this just to make sure that I get all the answers that I think I'm going to get. And did I get that twice? Did I get button store? There's button store, okay. And then if I have a short name, then I like red, and then I like magenta, and then I like not one of these, and then I didn't pick something. Okay. So basically the idea is, like I said, the reason I like this example is because it really shows you kind of all the different ways that this can work. You can combine concepts, you can nest concepts, you can just do all kinds of things. So as you're approaching a problem, don't just think about, well, I'm only able to solve it this way because this is what we're studying and this is what we're learning right now. Think about all the different ways that you can approach the problem.